Time to shift gears more than a little bit here and head into some IP version 6. And IP version 6, we're going to talk a little bit about why we had to develop another IP version, because what's wrong with IP version 4? Well, one reason we developed IP version 6, and I'm including myself in that, even though I didn't actually help, is that we were running out of routable addresses. So we had to come up with some new addresses, and the 128-bit addresses that we use in IP version 6 give us a huge number of addresses, and also it's designed specifically with route summarization in mind. And I know that you haven't done any summarization yet in this course, so very quickly, I just want to tell you that you can take certain routes, you can take maybe 8 routes, write them in binary, because that's what it always comes back to, and you can come up with a way to express multiple routes with a single route. That's what route summarization is. You might not have even heard anything I said for the last 30 seconds because you might be saying, excuse me, I'm sorry, what did you say about a 128-bit address? If that was your reaction, you are not alone, because I had the exact same reaction when IP version 6 really first came out, because I was actually studying for a major Cisco exam at the time. And someone mentioned something, oh, you know, IP version 6 is coming out now, et cetera. And I thought, you know, okay, they're just going to take the 4 octet, you know, the version 4 address and just add 2 to the end of it, right? And that's going to be it. Well, not exactly. But when you hear about these 128-bit addresses, you may think, I am going to be typing numbers for the rest of my life. And that is not the case. Once you get used to it, and once you work with IP version 6 more and more, which we're all going to have to do, then you'll actually appreciate the way version 6 was designed, and you'll appreciate these addresses. But at first, it is a whole new world. And I have found that even though version 6 has been around for quite a while now, a lot of people only learn it when they absolutely have to, like say right now, for instance. And there's nothing wrong with learning it right now, but the thing is, we need to embrace it and not be scared of it, because you know it's so widespread. You probably own devices in your home that you don't even know have version 6 IP addresses. You know, your refrigerator could have an IP version 6 address, and you don't even know it. And the thing is, it's going to get bigger and bigger and bigger as time marches on. And I can't tell you when IP version 4 is going to be totally gone, if that ever happens. But, you know, we've got to embrace version 6. And the reason I mention curing you of IP version 6 address anxiety is this is where I find all the problems come in with people who are scared of it. You know, I don't want to quite use that word. But the thing is, it's like, no, I've seen those addresses, and I don't want anything to do with that. You know, 128 bits, But you'll see they're actually pretty simple, and thankfully there are ways to compress them. So before we even get into any kind of routing or configuring interfaces or even talking about version 6 theory, we're going to work with these addresses first, because this is the kind of thing we're looking at. Just a sample version 4 address, 129.14.12.200. Well, there was a day for every single one of us where you didn't know what that was. You know, you looked at 129.14.12.200, so what's that? You know, how do we get that? And you learned it, and now you use it, and you don't even think about it. It's like counting from 1 to 10. You know, at one point in your life, that was difficult. And now you're just like, 1, 2, 3, 4, you don't think about it. You will be the same with version 6 addresses. We just have to get used to a couple of facts here. The first one is that we do have hex in here. And so we've got our values A through F. We know how to convert those, but we do have to get used to the fact you're not just working with 1 through 9 here. Hex is in there as well. And notice that we have 8 blocks. That's what I call them. That's what a lot of people call them. If you want to call them octets or something else, that's fine. But I just refer to them as blocks, and I'll try to do so through all of these videos. Keep it consistent. Now, a non-compressed version 6 address has 8 sections of 4 values. And this is an uncompressed IP version 6 address. And luckily for you and I, there are ways to compress these addresses so we don't have to enter so many numbers and letters. And just as a quick reminder, if you want to brush up on your hex, this is a good time to do it, but there is no difference between an uppercase letter and a lowercase letter in hex. We know that, but I just wanted to mention it as a reminder. 2 very simple rules when it comes to compressing IP version 6 addresses. It's going to be some of the simplest stuff you've ever seen. One has to do with zero compression, and another has to do with leading zero compression. Now, if you have consecutive fields of zeros, they can be expressed with 2 colons. or a double colon. It doesn't matter if you have two consecutive fields of zeros or eight consecutive fields of zeros, and I mean that, you can actually have eight sets of zeros, eight blocks of zeros. So instead of typing 0000, we're going to show you a better way to do that. You could type two colons and you're done. Now this is zero compression. We have zero compression and leading zero compression. And the thing is with zero compression is that you can only do it once per address. Once. So here's the original version 6 address, and we've got all those zeros right in the middle. So what we can do again with zero compression is represent multiple consecutive fields of zeros with a double colon. And that's it. So the same address with zero compression is 123.4.1.2.3.4, double colon, 3.4.5.6.3.4.3.4, and you're done. Pretty sweet, huh? So we knocked out a lot of typing right there, and we shortened the address quite a bit. Now, here's the original IP version 6 address, and you could use the double colon to represent one of those sets of consecutive zeros again, but only one. Now, with leading zero compression, that allows us to drop the leading zeros in any field. And the key rules with leading zero compression, and notice I have bolded leading here. It's not leading, it's not middle zero compression, it's not ending zero compression, it is leading zero compression. You drop the leading zeros in any field. Now, great news here, you can do this as often as you want. But two little rules here. You have to leave at least one number in each field, even if the field is all zeros. And you can perform leading zero compression as often as you need or desire in a single address. Now, you are allowed to use both of these techniques in a single address. You just remember the frequency rules and you're all set. So what would we do here with this address? And especially if this is the first time watching the video, go ahead and write it out. But you could also pretty much eyeball this one and say, okay, here's where I would do zero compression, here's where I would do leading zero compression. Now, a word, there is nothing illegal about this address, and there are different legal ways, even with compression, to express this. And just looking at this one, well, I'll show you the answers here in a moment, but I'm kind of going to do it now. You could do zero compression on that second and third block, put a double colon in there, and then just leave the rest of it alone. It is not a law of IP version 6 that you have to use as much zero compression and leading zero compression as you can. Now, in the real world, you're usually going to do that. But for exam purposes, keep that in mind because there are several legal ways of expressing any IP version 6 address that has at least one zero in it. So you just got to get used to that. So again, let's walk through that one. We look at the original address, and you can see how far we knocked that back. And the newly compressed address, we see the double colons there, and then we see a lot of zeros dropped off. We use zero compression to use a double colon to replace the second and third fields or blocks, which were both all zeros. Leading zero compression replaced the two zeros at the beginning of each of the last four blocks. So that's all there is to it. Now, on your exam in particular, and some son of a gun like me may try to trip you up on a job interview as well. Watch out for incorrectly expressed IP version 6 addresses, both in your exam and in the documentation, because we know if we try to violate those IP version 6 expression rules on live equipment, the router's not going to let you do it as you would expect. But what could happen, of course, on your exam, multiple choice questions, job interview, multiple choice questions, and we know you can eliminate these immediately, because if I gave you a list of 6 IP version 6 addresses and asked you, you know, which one does such and such, or well, what's the shortest legal expression for a particular address, you could eliminate anything that matches any of these 3 points I've put on the board. Because these aren't just illegal, they're immediately illegal. First off, if you see more than two consecutive colons, there's no such thing as a triple colon or a quadruple colon in IP version 6. If you see more than one set of double colons, it's over. You know that's an illegal address. And the letters from G through Z, we know those aren't hex characters. We stop at F, and we know those would be illegal. So if you saw choices like this, and I put the three dots here at the end just to say, hey, the rest of the address you don't even have to look at. Because the first one, you're going from left to right, you see four colons in a row, immediately illegal. Going from left to right with the second one, you see that second set of double colons following the threes, immediately illegal. And then we've got the letter H stuck in another address. You don't even have to look at the rest of it, because no matter how legal the rest of it is, that address is totally illegal. Now, I'm going to go ahead and put this here because this is just another minute or two. I know we're hitting the 10-minute mark, but I want to show you a quick word about uncompressing a compressed IP version 6 address. Because compressing, it's kind of letting the air out of it, and you got to uncompress it sometimes as well. Now, if you see that double colon, you know, the one legal one, and I know I'm hitting you over the head with that, but it's an important rule. Just put enough blocks of zeros back in until you have 8 blocks. So let's say that we were given this compressed address. You see 1234, 123, double A, double colon, 4 Bs, and then 3 Cs. Well, we see how many blocks right now? We see 5. We know that an IP version 6 address is going to have 8. So right then and there, you know that that double colon represents 3 blocks. So you just put those 3 blocks right back in the middle and you are ready to go. And now to finish uncompressing the address, all you have to do is put leading zeros in each remaining block until each block shows 4 values and you are all set. So at the top here is the address once I put my 3 blocks of zeros in that were compressed by 0 compression, and then the full expression, the first block is fine. Second block, you got to put 1 0 in because you got 3 values. Third block, you got to put 2 zeros in because you only had 2 values, the 2 A's. The 4 B's, that's fine. And then with the C's, you just put 1 leading zero in front of it. All there is to it. And I've mentioned this with certain other things in the course, but this is the kind of thing you can practice, you know, 5 minutes here, 10 minutes there. You got a few minutes taking a break. You don't even need a practice exam. You don't need any of that stuff. Just get a piece of paper and a pencil. Write out an address without really thinking about it and say, okay, how would I compress this? And then on exam day, because you know you're going to get asked something like that, bang. You know, it's just second nature. And that's what you want with binary and subnetting and anything to do with any kind of numbers on this exam. You just want to practice it to the point where it is absolutely automatic. That is enough compression for right now. Coming up, a few nuts and bolts about IP version 6 before we move on to a few configs. I'll see you there.